Well, we really didn't learn much of anything about nutrition in medical school. And even now, 20 years later, the average medical student gets 1 month of nutrition, if that. And it's usually about nutritional deficiencies. You know, vitamin C leads to scurvy and vitamin B leads to beriberi and things like that, which is really unfortunate. Now, hopefully that's going to be changing. I got interested in doing this when I was a second year medical student and I was learning how to do coronary bypass surgery with Michael DeBakey, the heart surgeon. And we cut people open, we bypass their clogged arteries, he'd tell them they were cured, and more often than not, they would go home and do all the things that had caused the problem in the first place. You know, smoke and eat junk food, not manage stress, not exercise. And more often than not, the bypasses would clog up and we'd cut them open again, sometimes two or three times. And so for me, we were literally bypassing the problem. We weren't really treating the underlying cause. And often when I lecture, I'll show a slide of doctors busily mopping up the floor on a sink that's overflowing, but nobody's turning off the faucet. And to a much larger degree than we had once realized, the underlying causes, turning off the faucet, if you will, are the lifestyle choices that we make each day. And even though we tend to think of advances in medicine as being a new drug or a new laser or something really high-tech and expensive, we're in our studies over the last almost 40 years now, we've used these very high-tech, expensive, state-of-the-art scientific measures to prove how powerful these very simple and low-tech and low-cost interventions can be. And we found for the first time that not only can you help prevent disease, but you can actually reverse it in most cases. First, we began with heart disease. Then we found that the progression of early stage prostate cancer may be slowed, stopped, and even reversed. Type 2 diabetes can be reversed, not only as well as with drugs, but even better at a fraction of the cost, and the only side effects are good ones. We found that when you change your lifestyle, it actually changes your genes and turns on the good genes that protect you and turns off the bad ones that tend to cause heart disease, diabetes, prostate, breast, colon cancer, and so on. And our latest studies were showing that you can even begin to reverse aging at a cellular level by lengthening telomeres, the ends of our chromosomes that control how long we live. And so, you know, I think these findings are really giving many people new hope and new choices that we didn't have before. You know, so much of the medical school curriculum has been influenced by things we can measure, by drugs and surgery. We are reimbursed for using drugs and surgery, so we're trained to use drugs and surgery. And so it became clear to me that it was not only important to do good science, but we also had to change reimbursement. And so after 16 years of going back and forth with Medicare and having them evaluate our work, they created a new benefit category. So now Medicare is now covering my program for reversing heart disease. And now that Medicare is paying for it, most of the other insurance companies are doing so as well. And if you change medical, if you change reimbursement, then ultimately you change medical practice and even medical education. And that's what's happening now. We're really creating a whole new paradigm of healthcare. Well, unfortunately, traditionally medicine has only reimbursed treatments, usually drugs and surgery. Now that's changing. And as we move into the era of Obamacare, whatever you think about it, it's really turning all the incentives on their ear, particularly when people are given bundled payments. Here's X amount of dollars to take care of somebody. You, the doctor, or the hospital, or the clinic gets to keep what's left over. So before, in a traditional fee-for-service environment, a volume-based environment, the more operations you do, the more hospitalizations, the more medications you prescribe, the more money you generate. Now it's more, here's X amount of dollars, you get to keep what's left over. So the fewer procedures you do, the more revenue is generated. And so now that, on the one hand, Medicare and many commercial payers are covering programs like mine, and there's a bonus at the end because you can reduce the need for surgery and drugs and hospitalizations, it's become a new paradigm of healthcare rather than sick care.